With the February release, the impact analysis option is now available for your standard and DSQL maps, and also for UTE structure. It allows you to identify the jobs, joblets or routes that use a map, but also the components that use a structure. Let's first take the example of a map. Right-click the customer's underscore orders map to analyze the jobs that use it. The impact analysis view appears, and the name of the jobs are displayed. In that case, we can see that the map is used in a standard job which is opened here, and also in a Spark batch job that you can choose to open from this view. Then, let's take the example of a structure. Right-click the customer's underscore orders structure to analyze the components that use it. The impact analysis view appears, and the name of the components are displayed. In this case, we can see that the structure is used in th-convert file in a Spark batch job. Note that this option is available only when you have installed the data lineage feature in Talend Studio Feature Manager. With the February release, Talend Studio offers you the possibility to use three new Milvus components to leverage query vector capabilities and process records in your Milvus databases. The goal here is to create a connection to a Milvus database, load data in a specific collection, and query this collection using vector embeddings. The first part of the job aims at creating a connection to a specific Milvus database by entering its endpoint URL, authentication token, and selecting the desired database. The next step aims at inserting data about data types into a Milvus collection using a T-fixed flow input component. T-Milvus output allows you to retrieve all the available Milvus collections and lets you select the desired one. In this use case, we are inserting the data into the collection named All Types. Finally, the last step here is to perform a search query in your vector database. To do so, configure the T-Milvus input component to perform a search operation using a global variable previously created as the query vector. The limit is set to 5, so only up to 5 records will be retrieved. Let's execute the job now. You can see that one row corresponding to the record added by the T-FixedFlow component has been inserted into the Milvus collection, and that 5 rows have been retrieved by the T-Milvus input component. The two T-log row components printed both the inserted line and the query result as tables. The 5 records present in the database that are nearest to the provided query vector are extracted from the Milvus database. In this release, two new Google Pub Sub components, cGoogle Pub Sub and cGCP Connection, are added for routes, allowing you to send messages to or receive messages from Google Cloud Pub Sub service. You can create connection to Google Cloud Pub Sub service by specifying your project ID in the cGCP Connection component. If you are not using credentials file, you need to set up Google application default credentials. If you are using credentials file, you need to create service account key via Google Cloud Identity and Access Management and enter the path to your credentials file in the cGCP Connection component. You can put class path, file, or HTTP prefix to load your credential file. In this demo route, two subroutes are built, a message producer route and a consumer route. In the producer route, the cTimer component triggers a message exchange. The cSetBody component sets a test message in constant language as the message body. The cGoogle Pub Sub component reuses the connection established in cGCP Connection and sends the message to the specified topic. In the consumer route, the cGoogle Pub Sub component consumes message from the subscription of the topic in the producer route. The clog components logs the message exchanges. Run the route. The test message is received by the consumer and printed in the execution console. In this release, a new cRabbitMQ component is added for routes, allowing you to send messages to or receive messages from RabbitMQ compliant message brokers. The cRabbitMQ component has to be used with cMQ Connection Factory, which creates a connection to an MQ server. For example, in this demo route, the cMQ Connection Factory component is configured to connect to the local RabbitMQ server. Two subroutes are built, a message producer route and a consumer route. In the producer route, the cTimer component triggers a message exchange. The cSetBody component is configured to set Hello World in constant language as the message body. The cRabbitMQ component reuses the connection established in cMQ Connection Factory and sends the message to the exchange MyQ. In the consumer route, the cRabbitMQ component is configured exactly the same as the producer. It consumes the messages from the exchange MyQ. The C-Log components logs the message exchanges. Run the route. The log messages are printed in the execution console. The message "Hello World" is sent to the RabbitMQ server and received by the consumer.